Well, our share market has had a tough day, fuelled by fears that Europe will not be able to stop another financial crisis. All of our major banks have finally passed on this week's rate cut, but it might be for the last time.
Unlike some at this time of year, even when our banks are giving, they're threatening to take away. The ANZ's announcement that from now on it will go it alone on interest rates may have changed the game forever.
Yeah, I think it's entirely possible in the future that you could see the Reserve Bank cutting rates and, in fact, the commercial banks increasing rates at the same time.
But I just make the point that when they take their decision, there will be very close scrutiny of that decision, and their customers will be able to judge whether they're offering competitive rates or not.
The Reserve Bank Governor says our banks have been going their own way for a while. The margin between the official rate and their loan rates has grown by as much as a full percent. Behaviour the RBA takes into account.
And for that reason, the cash rate is roughly 100 points lower than it would otherwise have been, because we've basically offset that widening.
There is a complicating factor in all of this, and it remains on the other side of the globe. And events in Europe this weekend could very well determine how much of an impact that all has.
And it isn't looking good.
Europe is faced with an extremely dangerous situation.
Crisis talks overnight in Brussels failed to secure a deal involving all 27 Eurozone countries aimed at saving the euro and heading off recession. Britain, among others, held out.
What was on offer wasn't good enough for Britain, so better to have those countries in a treaty on their own.
Countries using the single euro currency now have until March to secure a treaty. Eddie Meyer, 10 News.